Welcome, Citizen Graham. Where would you like to go?
Take me to my apartment.
Certainly, Citizen Graham.
There was one thing I was sure of. That was not a bonsai tree.
Excuse me, please.
I swapped the lens for the broken one from the lockbox. It was a secret message. Aspiration Gala. Midnight. Be there. The gala. That's tonight. And I need to be there.
Excuse me, Songbird?
What now?
So you're supposed to go to this Aspiration Gala?
Not anymore. After all these years, finally a high enough kudos level to get me to high places. And the Aspiration Gala? That was my chance to soar. The sort of kudos levels that are gonna be there, my status would skyrocket.
Sounds like fun.
It would have been. Now I'll never know. Thanks to you.
Are you still mad about the Aspiration Gala?
Yes!
How do you get invited to the Aspiration Gala?
If you have a high enough kudos level, you get tickets. Which I had until you came along.
Oh, right. Mentor Alonso.
Don't blame him. The only reason he even came here is because of Graham. Why didn't my husband just shut up, smile, and go to work like the rest of us? Instead of ranting and raving about conspiracies and all that nonsense.
Thanks.
Yeah, bye.
Excuse me, sir.
Hello again.
Good day, Master Grundy.
Are you going to the Aspiration Gala?
Going? One is headlining, sir.
What do you mean?
Yours truly is performing in front of the best and brightest of Union City.
Performing what?
Droid poetry, sir.
Oh, boy. So this poetry performance you mentioned, what's the story?
Ah. One has been invited to recite a humorous poem of one's own devising at tonight's Aspiration Gala.
You, a droid, have been tasked with writing a poem?
Oh, yes, sir. The poet laureate Reginald Arthur Schnipple, Esquire, performs regularly at the gala. And this year, he has invited me to open for him by reading an inspirational and humorous example of droid poetry on stage.
Droid poetry? How's that working out?
Very good, sir. Reginald has told me that whatever I read, it will be hilarious, and the people will laugh uncontrollably.
Hmm. Laugh at or laugh with?
Oh, is there a difference?
That's what I thought. If I gave you a bit of inspiration for your poem, could you get me into the gala?
Sir, that would be only fair. I'm sure Sir would enjoy the fruits of that inspiration at the performance.
I realized if I could help Tarquin with his poem, he could get me into the gala.
So just to be clear, I give you inspiration, you get me into aspiration.
Inspiration for aspiration. That's rather clever. And it rhymes. Sir's genius is luminescent.
In that case, let me go see what I can find. Later, Tarquin.
Have a good day, Mr. Grun Day. Excuse me, sir.
Welcome, Citizen Graham. Where would you like to go?
The piazza is the place for me.
It would be my pleasure, Citizen Graham.
Tarquin's master, Reginald, was supposed to be around here somewhere.
Union City wishes all citizens a happy aspiration.
Hey there. Hey there.
Oh. Hey, how are you?
What are you doing here?
Can't you tell? I'm a diagnostician.
Diagnostician? Do you actually fix stuff?
No, Joey. They just scan the problem.
And Minos fixes it.
Kinda like you're a hacker thing, Foster. Hey, my friend can hack stuff for-
Whoa there, Joey. I'm sure the nice lady isn't interested in that. I like your scanner.
Thanks. Load of junk, really. I prefer a good old-fashioned spanner.
You'd love mine.
Hey, where'd you get that? You don't look like a diagnostician.
It's, for cleaning.
Uh-oh, Foster. I think she's on to us.
What are you listening to?
You wouldn't know them.
Give me a shot. I'm surprisingly hip.
Hip? You actually said hip, didn't you?
Bye for now.
Yeah, cool.
Looking for an eccentric poet, and Reginald certainly fit the bill.
Droink, what is the meaning of the horrible music playing in the VIP lounge?
Apologies, citizen. Would you like to file a report and request the technician look into your problem?
Of course! I would like this remedied immediately.
Affirmative. Your request has been noted. this issue will be solved as soon as possible. Thank you for your patience.
How soon?
Unknown. Thank you for your patience.
Excuse me.
What is it?
Reg?
Yes?
I'm looking for some inspiration on writing poetry.
My dear boy, please do not mistake these luscious locks for those of a creative muse.
I just figured you could help me out.
Listen, I'll stick to...
Later, Reggie.
See you tonight, or perhaps not.
Please scan your user to place an order.
Attention, citizen. You are present at the scene of an active alarm.
Did I do something wrong?
That remains to be seen. Do you have any information on the cause of the alarm?
I didn't see a thing.
Very well. Do not panic. Minos will soon relate to me the identity of the culprit. Incident logged. You may go about your business.
Please scan your user to place an order.
I ventured one day to my favorite cafe to partake in a wonderful scene. For I love Union City. The colors of...
Social climbers. Customize your aspiration brooch here. Happy Aspiration Day, sir. Please choose your desired hologram.
It'll have to be the Joey hologram for me. I just love him so much.
Wonderful choice. You'll stand tall above your fellow citizens. There, your aspiration brooch is ready to collect.
Thanks.
Calling all social climbers. Customize...
I now had Reginald's poetry on my aspiration brooch. Just what Tarquin was after.
Union City wishes all citizens a happy Aspiration Day.
Welcome, Sid. Where would you like to go?
Take me to my apartment.
Certainly, Citizen Graham.
Excuse me, sir.
Got a minute?
Apologies if my loquacious musings disturbed one.
Hello again.
Good day, Master Grundy.
I've found you some inspiration.
Bravo, sir. And where was it?
It's always in the last place you look.
Would sir care to share?
Absolutely. Here you go.
Oh, sir. What an assembly of words. This will have the humans sitting with their backs against the backs of their chairs and their arms upon the armrests. This is sure to conjure heightened emotions from Master Reginald when one reads it.
Oh, you bet.
I don't want to find out which emotions.
Thank you, sir. Now, may one bestow upon sir a token of gratitude?
If by that you mean hand me a ticket to the gala, then yes.
One does indeed.
Thank you, Tarquin. And best of luck at the performance.
No, sir. Thank you. This will be a night to remember. Oh, there is one small issue, sir.
What's that?
I do believe your attire is somewhat inadequate for the soiree this eve. Perhaps I can find something for you.
That'd be most appreciated.
Looking sharp, Rob.
Joey?
I hear you.
You think Reginald is going to be mad when Tarquin reads his poem?
Absolutely. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Let's talk later, Joey.
Okay, Foster. Hey, Foster. Remember back in the gap when you made that thing? Tin cans all tied together, clunking around in the wind. And you said it was art. This is better.
Commencing refill.
You changed clothes. What's the occasion?
I knew Songbird was upset that she wasn't going to the gala. I'm going to the Aspiration Gala. I think the people who took the kids might be there.
You toad!
That's my party! I should be there! What a nightmare! My husband goes mad, falls in with a conspiracy nut, and starts taking photos of things he really shouldn't! Then you show up! Well, I hope you're happy.
Songbird, I...
No, no more talking. You go to the party. You have fun looking for kids. See how far that gets you. If I ever see you again, it'll be too damn soon.
As I stared at the opulence of this Aspiration Gala extravaganza, my eye was caught by a movement on a walkway. These had to be the people that I was looking for. The people who would lead me to Milo. I had to find a way to get up to that walkway and find out where they were going.
Curb that human instinct, Foster. This is no time for snacks.
They really were fancy sandwiches. The crusts had been cut off. Much as I loved Wendell's Mini-K, I didn't think this fancy party was the right place. I hope this welcome sign was better maintained than the last one I'd seen. Hey, Raquel. Good to see you.
Sir, and you are...
Graham Grundy, remember?
Have we met before, sir?
It was odd. She really didn't recognize me. Well, sure, at the apartments. You nearly fell?
No, I'd definitely remember something like that, don't you think? Anyway, I see you've got your ticket, but...
But?
This is a general entry ticket, not a VIP ticket. I'm afraid that you don't have access to this area. I'm so sorry. Enjoy the rest of the gala.
I had no need to enter the VIP section. I was here for the secret meeting.
I'm very sorry, Mentor Alonso. I don't know what happened.
It won't do, Astrid. Won't do at all. This is the Aspiration Gala, after all.
Yes, sir, of course.
And you said you believe the firework projector was tampered with?
I'm not entirely sure, but it was working perfectly during the rehearsals.
Regardless, I trust that the issue really is now resolved, and that you'll be keeping a closer eye on things from now on.
Oh, yes, sir.
And you won't have to keep leaving your station unsupervised.
Absolutely not. You can count on me.
Now, back to work, Mr. Grundy, what a pleasant surprise. Of course, Aspiration Day always does deliver surprises.
It's all about who you know, isn't it?
Indeed. I'd be very interested to find out more about who exactly you know.
Is Officer Arana coming tonight?
Why do you ask? Are you in need of well-being support?
He loves her.
No, I just assumed she'd be here.
Well, as a matter of fact, she was here a moment ago. You must have just missed her.
Where did she go?
I have no idea. A busy little bee, that one.
So, what are you doing here, Alonzo?
I'm here to supervise everyone's well-being.
Like Officer Arana?
Officer Arana was in charge of the preparations. I'm here to make sure the event itself runs smoothly.
Sounds like a tough gig.
It won't be. Things never go wrong in Union City.
How's it all going, Alonzo?
Smooth sailing, as expected. Let's keep it that way, yes?
Enjoying the party?
The Aspiration Gala never fails to put a smile on my face. And I look forward to Reginald's poetic display with undiluted pleasure. His past efforts have always been so amusing.
That girl who was at my apartment building this morning? She's acting a little strange.
Strange how?
She seems to have totally forgotten we met.
Does she seem unwell? Troubled?
Well, no, but...
Then I don't see the problem, Mr. Grundy. Everything looks perfectly in order to me.
Right. I was wondering if you'd seen any odd behavior at the party.
Odd? Suspicious how?
You know what? Never mind. Sorry to have bothered you.
No bother, Mr. Grundy. But I must warn you, if you've observed any suspicious behavior, you must report it to the relevant authority immediately.
Understood, Mentor Alonzo.
What he said.
I'll see you around.
Do keep a smile on your face, Mr. Grundy.
Foster, word of advice. Never trust a guy with big eyebrows. Okay. inconvenience anybody just to get your own way, won't you, Foster?
Come on, Joey, we're going up in the world.
This had to be where the shadowy figure had come from. If there was some way to access the side of the building, maybe I could follow that strange figure. Much as I loved Wendell's Mini K, I didn't think this fancy party was the right place. Who knew a party needed so many servers? Hey, Joey.
Is this really the best time to talk about your feelings? Get a move on!
Who knew a party needed so many servers?
We're going through the vent.
Age before beauty.
If you say so.
Oh, man. Forgot how old this shell was. Okay, move. Can't say I'm not a droid of my word. Well?
Thank you, Joey.
Judge a society on its firework parties. I don't know why I say it. Just make
it look like Tarquin and Reginald were about to perform. The excitement was bearable. I was so close to finding answers. I had to go now.
Jeez, Foster. I expected you to be in better shape.
Shut up, Joey, and keep an eye out. That vehicle. It's the same as the one that stole Milo. Guess that means we're in the right place.
Foster, look out!
Arana?
You!
Arana, stop!
Yeah, Arana, stop!
I'm not who you think I am.
I know you're not Graham Grundy. You've been lying to me since the moment we met. What the hell have you done with the real Graham? And who the hell are you?
My real name is...
Robert!
Danielle Piermont?
The lady from the museum?
What on earth is a nice boy like you doing in a back alley like this?
Arana, dear, please! You can stop!
But...
His mother and I were at school together. You can trust him, I promise.
Can someone please explain what the hell is going on?
Graham Grundy is dead.
You killed him for his ID?
Robert!
Ah, dude. That's harsh.
No. I found Graham's body outside the gates. He'd been dead for days. I was looking for a child who was kidnapped in one of those vehicles. I needed a way into the city. Graham's ID was the answer.
The poor boy.
I told him not to try anything stupid. This is all my fault.
Oh, Rana, dear, don't be hard on yourself. Graham knew what he was doing.
My name is Robert Foster. I've come from the Gap. A few days ago, one of those vehicles attacked my village. The androids were armed. We couldn't stop them. They took my friend, Milo. He's just a kid.
This is just awful!
So you were both friends with Graham?
I didn't think he had any friends.
Friends, allies, whatever you want to call it.
Graham was working at the land train entrance when he saw one of these things coming into the city.
These things? You mean the stalkers?
I thought they were called creepers.
We call them walkers. Whatever they're called. Here comes another one.
Girl in the stalker. I recognized her.
Ember.
Graham was right. Those things are carrying children. Whatever they're doing to them.
It's inside that building.
Then that's where I'll find Milo.
Now then, I must get back to the gala. I fear my absence from the festivities may already be apparent. You two, find out where they're taking those children.
Two? You mean three, don't you?
That's my plan.
Lovely to see you again, Robert.
You too, Miss Piermont.
Oh, and Arana?
Yes?
Trust him. He's from good stock.
That elevator transported the stalker into the building.
We need to find a way to get it working.
What if another one of those big beasts shows up?
Okay, I'll keep watch. Reckon you and your sidekick can figure it out.
Huh. We got this far.
She was talking to me, Rob.
Can you see a button anywhere?
I don't think this place was designed for visitors. Foster, I have auto-linked to the system. Perhaps.
Come on, there's no way.
You were saying?
Hey, Arana, we found a way.
Quite a hit there.
What's going...
It's okay, Foster. Just lie still. Don't be afraid. I'm here now.
Joey. You're Joey.
It's good to see you, Foster.
Where am I?
It's okay. You're safe now.
There was an explosion. Orana, what's happened to...
Don't worry. Everything's going to be all right.
Joey, it's so good to see you again. I should have come back earlier.
Hey, it's no problem.
Could have helped you.
No need, old friend. The Council have everything under control.
But that's just it. The Council. You have to stop them. They're...
Shh. Calm now. Plenty of time to talk when you're better. Need to get you fixed first.
Fixed? What do you mean?
Just relax, old friend. Soon have that smile back on your face.
This doesn't make any sense.
Guess I got what it takes. These doors just opened for me.
Joey, get back!
Huh? Don't shoot!
Confirmed. Welcome to level 4 UG.
That went well.
I'll say. Are we allowed to be here?
I just got it. The system is finally recognizing me for who I truly am. Joey.
Great. That means you can disable the android?
If this shell had any sort of weapon, it would be a whole lot easier. But I'll give it a go. Wait right here.
Right here. Brilliant.
This is my time to shine. That android is heading for a fall.